In this video, we're looking at a problem that starts with a block sliding on a smooth horizontal surface, and it runs into a spring. And the questions we're looking at this time are a little bit different than usual. In part A, we want the time for the bounce to occur. So this block is going to come into contact with the spring, reach a maximum compression, extend back to the equilibrium position, and then the block separates from the spring again. And the key to the problem is to realize that while the block is in contact with the spring, we're looking at a simple harmonic oscillator. And in fact, the bounce occurs during exactly 1/2 of a period for this simple harmonic oscillator. So all we have to do for part A is remember the formula for the period of a simple harmonic oscillator, and that's 2 pi square root of m over k. And we plug in the numbers, the block had a mass of 2.58 kilograms, and the spring constant was given to us as 28 newtons per meter. And when we run the numbers on this, we get a period of 1.907 seconds. Now that would be the time for one full oscillation of a simple harmonic oscillator. That would be all the way from the equilibrium position to full compression to full extension back to equilibrium. What we're looking at in this problem is actually just 1/2 of a period. We go from equilibrium to full compression back to equilibrium. So we need 1/2 that period. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 0.954 seconds. Now in part B, we're asked to compute the average force exerted on this block by the spring during the bounce. And the key to this problem is to realize that we can compute average force by looking at the change in momentum divided by the change in time. And in fact, to be a little more precise about it, we're going to do this in the vector form here, where rightward is indicated by a plus sign and leftward is indicated by a minus sign. So we need the initial momentum of the block and the final momentum of the block, and P initial is just mv initial. We plug in the mass, 2.58 kilograms. We plug in the initial velocity, positive, 1.75 meters per second, because we're keeping track of direction with plus and minus signs. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 4.515 kilogram meters per second. Now to get the final momentum, we have to think at least briefly about energy conservation. So we don't have any friction forces acting here. I know the energy is conserved in this system. And I have some initial kinetic energy in this block. That's converted to spring potential energy at the maximum compression point, and then that spring releases again, all the spring potential energy is gone, and it all turns into kinetic energy again. Well, if energy is conserved, then the final kinetic energy must be equal to the initial. And since it's the same mass for the block, it means it has to have the same speed. So we immediately find out that the block is returning to the left at the exact same speed it originally approached the spring. So when we compute our final momentum, mv final, I plug in the mass, 2.58. And then based on that energy conservation argument, I know the speed is the same as the initial speed, but I'm going to put a minus sign on that to indicate that the velocity points to the left. This gives me a negative 4.515 kilogram meters per second. So when we plug into our average force formula, I have a delta P, or a P final minus P initial. That's negative 4.515 minus another 4.515 divided by the time for the bounce, which we computed in part A, and that's 0.954 seconds. And when we run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, we get negative 9.47 newtons for the average force. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.